In honor of Valentine's Day this weekend, I'm going to talk about the most popular flower of the holiday. Roses. Now, roses have been around for much longer than humans, for millions of years. Fossils of rosaceous species have been found in North America, Europe, Asia, and Africa. The earliest are primarily from the Eocene period, which spanned 56 to 33.9 million years ago. This was in the early part of the Cenozoic era, also known as the Age of Mammals. These rose-like species eventually evolved into the wild roses that we see today. Wild roses, however, probably don't look like what you would think of as roses. Roses are in the family Rosaceae and normally have only 5 petals, like this one. The rose family also includes important food crops, like apples, pears, and cherries. The cut roses people give by the dozens are cultivated roses that have been bred over time to have more petals and grow differently than their wild counterparts. The first cultivated roses were grown around 5,000 years ago, possibly in China. Cultivated roses were created through the accidental or purposeful crossbreeding of wild roses to create new varieties with desirable characteristics. This might include petal color, stem length, smell, or even when they flower. Today, there are literally thousands of varieties of roses, including those that are meant to be grown in gardens and those intended for mass production on cut flower farms. Roses are the most popular cut flower in the United States, outpacing carnations by more than double. In 2005, the US imported 1.3 billion stems of roses and produced almost 99 million domestically. That means 1.4 billion stems of roses in 1 year. Yes, it would appear that we are enamored with roses. Most of the United States cut flowers come from Central and South America, primarily Colombia. Holland, as you might expect, is the largest producer of cut flowers in the world, but due to distance, they only contribute a small percentage of US imports. Ecuador also contributes a large portion of US imports, especially roses. Roses are grown in plastic greenhouses where they can be protected from the elements. Growing roses is a delicate process, and no farm wants to lose valuable blossoms to a rough storm. Pesticides and herbicides are used in the growing process, some of them illegal in the United States when we're referring to non-domestically grown roses. An example in roses is the use of fungicides to prevent botrytis, a fungus that ruins flower petals. Flowers might literally be dipped in fungicide before leaving the farm. That's something to keep in mind the next time you buy yourself a bouquet. As you might guess, Valentine's Day is the busiest day of the year for florists. At flower farms, growers will cap flowers starting in December and January to prevent them from blooming until they're needed. 1/3 of the year's cut flower sales happen at Valentine's Day. Alright, hopefully now you know a little bit more about the flowers you might be giving or receiving this weekend. I got a lot of the information for this video from the book Flower Confidential by Amy Stewart, which I highly recommend if you're looking for more information on the flower industry. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe for more botany content, and I will see you next time.